बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड यू सी अ मैप ऑफ पाकिस्तान एंड इन द रेक्टेंगल मार्क्ड यू सी फैसलाबाद। आई वॉज बॉर्न इन फैसलाबाद एंड आई स्टडीड अंटिल इंटरमीडिएट इन फैसलाबाद। एंड ऑन द राइट साइड यू सी द क्लॉक टावर in the center of the heart of the city of the Faisalabad. Faisalabad, it was known previously as Lyallpur, after the name of the Sir James Lyall, who designed and incurred the idea of building a city between Lahore and Jhang at the end of the 19th century, 1890. This is the picture of the world-renowned King Edward Medical College, where I graduated from in 1979. I am Professor Imtiaz Ahmed, graduate of KE Medical College, Lahore. And postgraduate student of Postgraduate Medical College, Lahore. I have served in this college as principal of Abwa Medical College from March 2018 to March 2019. Currently, I am serving as professor and head of anatomy department, Abwa Medical College, Faisalabad. Previously, I served as professor and head of anatomy department at Punjab Medical College, Faisalabad, at Qaid-e-Azam Medical College, Bahawalpur, in the College of Medicine, King Faisal University, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, at Muhtarma Benazir Bhutto Shaheed Medical College, Mirpur, AJK. The anatomy department in the Abwa Medical College has the staff headed by myself. With me, Dr. Humaira Gul is serving as associate professor. Dr. Farhat Alam is serving as assistant professor. And Dr. Tajdar serving as demonstrator. While in the anatomy department, you will study general anatomy in lectures, gross or macroscopic anatomy by demonstrations, and surface anatomy by demonstration, radiological anatomy in lectures, developmental anatomy, that is embryology, and microscopic anatomy, histology, in lectures and in lectures and practicals. In the anatomy department, the lecture halls are 5. In lecture hall 1 or lecture theater 1, at the ground floor, you will study lectures. The section hall is on the 3rd floor. You will dissect cadavers in the dissection hall. And the demonstration rooms are on the 3rd floor. You will get demonstrations there at the 3rd floor. And the histology lab, that is again on the 3rd floor. And we have got a museum that is again on the 3rd floor. So practically all the practical work is in the 3rd floor, and only lectures are to be delivered on the ground floor in lecture theater 1. Recommended books in gross anatomy by the university are the Clinical Anatomy by Regents by Richard S. Snell, 9th edition, Clinical Oriented Anatomy by K.L. Moore, Gray's Anatomy for Students by Richard L. Grant's Dissector of Anatomy by Patrick W. Tank, Cunningham's Manual of Practical Anatomy, that is also a dissector, Grant's Atlas of Anatomy, latest edition, 2017. Then General Anatomy, our local author, Professor Tasadduq Hussain Sheikh, Embryology, The Developing Human Being by K.L. Moore, 10th edition, Langmuir's Medical Embryology by T.W. Saddle, Human Embryology by myself, Imtiaz Ahmed, Histology, Jankira's Basic Histology, and DeFury's Atlas of Histology. No one single book is prescribed, because this is a professional college. You are to study from the book which you like the most, each book has got different approaches and different appreciations. So you will go through the books, and the book which you like, that you would follow. In the dissection hall, in the demonstration rooms, in the lecture theaters, while you are in class, there are a few things which you must follow. You must have a good pencil and a notebook for short notes while sitting in the dissection hall or in the lab or in the museum or in the lecture theater. You must take some notes and revise them when you go back home, and keep them safe in your custody, because near the end of the study you will get many, many helps from those notes. In the class, cell phones are not allowed. Or if you have cell phones, please make them silent or put them off. So practically no cell phones. While in the class, eating and drinking is prohibited. If you want to eat something, if you want to drink something, if you feel hungry, if you are feeling thirsty, please go out, take whatever you like, then come back. So must be sitting in the academic environment active. Don't be yawning, or don't be going slow, and don't try to sleep in the academic environment. So actively you should be involved in studying, and try to avoid yawning, because this is a contagious procedure which travels from one person to the next. So no murmuring and humming. So when you are in the lecture theater or in the lab or in the dissection hall, mutual talks, mutual humming is prohibited. You should be concentrating on the studies only and only. So anything which deviates you from the concentration environment, that is nose cleaning and throat hawking, you should avoid it. If you feel anything wrong, you should go out, clean your nose and clean your throat, and then come back again and sit peacefully and quietly and with concentration in the academic environment. Don't disturb others, while if you are disturbed yourself. If you need something to go out, you are allowed freely. You are not needed to ask the professor or the lecturer. You can go out without any permission to the washrooms, etc. So with these few remarks, I will come to the introduction of the subject of anatomy. Anatomy is simply defined as a science which is concerned with the study of the structure of biological organisms. Focusing on human anatomy, the definition may be defined as study of the structure of the human body. The structure and the functions are intimately related. Thus, a more accurate definition would be the study of structure and its relation to the functions in the human body. The term anatomy, it has a Greek origin. That means to cut up or to dissect. The first scientifically based anatomical study that is credit of Vesalius, a 16th century Flemish anatomist. So what is Flemish? This is a prehistoric area in the Netherlands and in the France and in the Belgium. Now currently this area is in the Kingdom of Belgium. This Flemish anatomist, that is, now you can call it as a Belgian anatomist, he was a physician and artist and anatomist. He based his observations with unaided eye on dissected cadavers. But the contemporary human anatomy includes additional modes of observation. So traditional anatomy, that is by simple unaided eye observations of the cutting specimens. The other disciplines has been contributed by as subdivisions or subdisciplines of the anatomy. It is now common to precede the word anatomy with an adjective that defines the mode of observation. That is, gross anatomy or microscopic anatomy defines a particular field of anatomical interest. Developmental anatomy or neuroanatomy, or defines the approach one takes in the study of the body. Regional anatomy by body regions, or systemic anatomy by biological systems. Additional terms are common to the medicines: radiographic anatomy, clinical anatomy. So a true appreciation for the anatomy of the human body encompasses study in many, if not all, of the anatomical subdivisions. A few of the common subdivisions are applied anatomy. This is the practical application of the anatomy, typically in diagnostic and therapeutic clinical procedures. That is, the application of anatomical knowledge during performance of a physical examination. Clinical anatomy, it is the study of the anatomy that is most relevant to the practice of medicine. Comparative anatomy, it is the study of the anatomies of different organisms, drawing contrasts and similarities between the structure and function of the anatomies. Cross-section anatomy, it is the anatomy that is viewed by transverse sections, that is, horizontal sections, that is, in the horizontal plane of the body, is cut down and you study the transverse or cross sections of the body. development anatomy. This is the study of the biological processes that extend from fertilization to the formation of the adult anatomy. Embryology is a subdivision of developmental anatomy that is concerned exclusively with the developmental processes that occur prior to birth. Gross anatomy, the usual anatomy which is referred. It is the study of the anatomy with the unaided eye. It is essentially a visual observation without the use of significant magnifying technologies. Microscopic anatomy, that is histology. It is the study of the anatomy with the help of light microscope. Contemporary microscopic anatomy would also include observations using transmission and scanning electron microscopes that provide subcellular observations. Neuroanatomy, it is the study of the central and peripheral nervous systems. Radiographic or the radiological anatomy. It is the study of the anatomy as observed with imaging techniques that are derived from the diagnostic and therapeutic tools of clinical fields of radiology. Within the clinical practice, commonly includes plain film radiography with or without contrasting material, magnetic resonance imagery, that is MRI, computed tomography, that is CT scans, and ultrasonography or ultrasounds. Regional anatomy, it is the study of anatomy by regions of the parts of the body, that is thorax, upper limb, lower limb, abdomen, head and neck, etc. Under this mode of study, all of the biological systems, that is skeletal, circulatory, muscular, etc., located within a particular body region are simultaneously studied, with an emphasis on the interrelations of the systems and their regional functions. So if you are studying the upper limb, you are studying all the structures present in the upper limb. You are studying the nerves of the nervous system. You are studying the muscles of the myology. You are studying the nerves of the neurology, etc. Surface anatomy. It is the anatomy as it occurs on and projects to external surface of the body, particularly important in the performance of diagnostic and therapeutic clinical procedures. It includes both that which can be directly palpated on the body surface, underlying bone or muscle, as well as that which cannot be directly palpated, a deeply positioned organ. In the latter, knowledge of the surface projections of the organ contributes to applied anatomy, positioning a stethoscope on the chest wall so as to maximize the audition of the heart sounds. Surgical anatomy. This is the application and study of anatomy as it relates to the surgery, which itself may be defined as the diagnostic or therapeutic manipulation of anatomy. Systemic anatomy, that is the study of the anatomy by biological systems, that is skeletal system, osteology, muscular system, myology, clinical systems, circulatory systems, etc. In this mode of study, A single biological system is studied concurrently across all body regions. Meaning thereby, if you are studying muscles, you are studying the muscles of the whole body. If you are studying the nerves, you are studying the nerves of the whole body. If you are studying the bones, you are studying the bones of the whole body. So with this, we conclude our lecture on the introduction of the Department of Anatomy, the staff of the anatomy, and the subject of anatomy. From next time, I will go on with the subject of embryology, that is the study of the human being developing inside the womb of the mother from the fertilization till formation of the baby inside the uterus and its birth afterwards at the time of parturition. Thank you very much.